At Avera, high quality is high priority. Not just for the statistics, but for the people we serve. Every patient, every time. The face of quality at Avera.
It's a tale of two complete strangers, brought together at a time they needed all the support they could get. Both South Dakota tough guys, both with the same last name of Anderson, and both with painful back pain.
We're thinking this is just all part of getting older, and so kind of just rubbed a little dirt on it and figured it would be okay.
And my back was just killing me, and finally it got to the point where I couldn't stand anymore. After finally listening to my wife and deciding we need to go to the doctor.
They both came to the Avera Cancer Institute's Hematology and Bone Marrow Transplant Group. Doctors told both men their pain was actually multiple myeloma, a cancer of the plasma cells which causes bone deterioration.
It took us off guard with you just don't expect that, you know.
So people get broken bones, whether it be hip or pelvis or almost any bone, but vertebrae would be very common as well, so your spine and your backbones.
A life-changing diagnosis from Avera's Dr. Kelly McCall, but one these two men would not go through alone. After a diagnosis right around the same time, their treatment brought them to an Avera waiting room. A nurse told them they were both Andersons, and from there, the rest is history, earning them a new nickname on the floor.
The Anderson twins?
It hasn't been an easy road, but it's one these two friends have walked together. Their treatment has been almost identical. Both started with chemotherapy. After they showed a good response, both had stem cells collected, then went through a stem cell transplant. Through all of that, they've been by each other's side. They become close with each other's families and offered each other support they both call priceless.
Some of the things that happen through treatment are happening, is supposed to happen because it happens with somebody else and with the same thing. So you feel a little comfort level that way, and to explain it to somebody else sometimes is a little difficult.
We kind of followed each other's path, which is really good, because not that I knew we had all the answers, but, we kind of compared notes on how we felt after the collection. What to expect.
They both attend support groups together, check in on each other over the phone, and see each other when they get treatment at the hospital. They're both in remission and take a chemo pill 21 days on and 7 days off. They also receive bone strengthening medication, usually on the same day, side by side. They'll tell you whoever gets there first gets the comfy chair. As their journey continues, so will this fateful friendship. Support that no doubt helped on their long road to recovery.
I can pretty much ask him anything, and he feels the same way about me. And
it's been, like I say, a blessing, because you have somebody else to lean on.
I think that people tend to do better when they do have a good support group with them, whether that be family or friends or other individuals. No question, I think they do better.